Hi, Linda here, and I want to thank a YouTube friend, subscriber, for sending me this article. And this is kind of a tragic article I'm going to read to you. It's about Monsanto. Hold on, let me get there. Another win for Monsanto. U.S. raises allowable levels of companies' pesticide in crops. Biotech giant Monsanto has been awarded yet another victory by the federal government, thanks to a recent Environmental Protection Agency decision to allow larger traces of the herbicide glyphosate in farm-grown foods. Despite a number of studies linking exposure to the chemical with diseases, including types of cancer, the EPA is increasing the amount of glyphosate allowed in oilseed and food crops. The EPA announced their plans on May 1st and allowed critics 2 months to weigh in and object to the ruling. Following little opposition, and that's my ass, you know, yeah. There was a lot of opposition to this. Though the EPA is on the path to soon approve of levels of glyphosate being found in crops several times over the current concentration. Now, if you don't know what it is, it's in Roundup Ready. It's in the Roundup Ready seeds. Glyphosate is just as toxic poison in the GMO products. Now, I'm going to read you how much they're going to increase this. This is going to blow your mind. Through the EPA's new standards, the amount of allowable glyphosate in oilseed crops, such as flax, soybean, and canola, will be increased from 20 parts per million to 40 parts per million, which GM Watch acknowledged is over 100,000 times the amount needed to induce breast cancer cells. Additionally, the EPA is increasing limits on allowable glyphosate in food crops from 200 parts per million, which is excessively high, as that is, to 6,000 parts per million. That's insanity. Now, there's a lot of the critics leave their studies down here, but I want to go to what this one doctor says. Dr. M. Huber, emeritus professor of plant pathology at Purdue University, found in yet another examination that glyphosate draws out the vital nutrients of living things, in turn removing most nutritional value from GMO foods. In other words, what you're eating is nothing but poison, which we knew anyway. Some people probably thought they might have been getting a little bit of nutrients, but you're going to, even if you were, it was mixed with poison, but you're absolutely going to get no nutrients whatsoever. You're going to exist off of poison if you're not organic. And we here we have our own garden, and we eat as organic as possible, because you never know if you're 100% organic or not. But this right here is just unacceptable. And I like what they did in Oregon, if some of you know what they did with the beet crops there. I don't know what it's going to take for us to beat them, but no one has consulted with the little farmers who grow organic about this, I know, or even told people who grow this stuff, you know, food at home, about what they're doing. This is unacceptable from the servants of our government. And I say servants because that's what they're supposed to be. And they award this to Monsanto. Wasn't there probably some organic company saying, hey, I have heirloom seeds, let's try our stuff instead of using this? I'm sure there was. But they, you know, Monsanto, Bill Gates, I mean, we've got to put an end to this madness. The empires have got to fail. They've got to fail so we can live and so we can save this earth. Anyway, I love you all. Peace, love, and truth always. Linda.